Hello, everybody, and welcome to this beautiful live that Kara and I are doing. I brought back someone that I know you all love so much, Miss Kara Melendy. Go ahead, say hello to everybody.
Oh, thank you, Deanna. I'm happy to be here and looking forward to this today. It's always fun when we team up. And yeah, just this conversation around feminine flow and how it plays a role in our business, because I know we both embody that so much. And I feel like it can support so many people and shift away from just the old paradigm of doing business, the old masculine structure, into a new way, new possibility.
Yeah. And I was reflecting, Kara, on earlier today, I was reflecting on how you and I run very different businesses than the average person. Mm-hmm. And I love that we've been able to cultivate such powerful success and impact and influence and service by staying true to our intuitive gifts and staying true to our feminine energy, and that we can have structure and use strategy, but that isn't the focal point, that it's more about who we are being and the energy that we're exuding. And that's what allows us to create that abundance and success. And that's what we're going to talk about today.
Yay, I'm so excited. So excited. Yeah, it's so true, right? What we do really isn't like mainstream. But when I think about, I mean, this is aligned to my soul path, I have no doubt. And it's also what has brought so much success as well. Like when I first started, it was very, you know, I talked about balanced living and stress management, and it was maybe more accessible to a lot of people, but never really spoke to my soulmate client or lit me up in the way that like what I talk about now and what I teach now does. So.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. I can very much relate. Hello to Heather. I see that you have said hello to us. And Lisa, I have my phone here so I can see your guys' names. Hi, Lisa. I'm so happy you're here. Comment in if you are with us live. And Kara, to what you just said, I started, my company was called Vitality Pure. I worked solely as a holistic health coach. I was working with individuals on their fitness and their food, which I am passionate about, but I learned I'm not passionate about that to the extent that I can create an entire successful business from it. It's the spiritual aspect. It's the intuitive aspect, the energy aspect that brought so much more liveliness to me. And that's what I really feel when I watch your lives, when I engage with what it is that you're sharing, when I have been in workshops with you or received from you as that mentor and leader, is there is this sense of aliveness within you because you're living your passion. And I really admire that in you, Kara. It comes across so strongly. It's really beautiful.
Thank you, Deanna. Yeah. And I feel like that it's just so important for all of us, that what we do lights us up. And even in terms of actually like growing and expanding your business, that energy of fun is magnetic. Like yeah. I remember one of my first mentors that I hired, and I was actually reflecting on this earlier and thinking like she was actually a trained Akashic practitioner too. And at that time she was supporting me in growing my business, but it's just interesting to kind of see the connection. Like even before I really dove into the records, I was drawn to people that like use that modality. But I remember she told me like having fun is actually like what really grows and expands your business. And when she looked back and really noticed the shift, it was when she just started being really playful about it. Mm-hmm. And it always stuck with me. And it's definitely, you know, it's not something we force, right? People know if we're genuinely like passionate about what we're doing or if we're not, but it is, you know, it's just an important intention. Like we get to play, we get to have fun. And I feel that so much of the divine feminine energy as well, right? Is playing and creating just for the pure joy of it without it leading anywhere. But a fun side effect of it is it will grow your business and people will be drawn to that passion. Yeah.
Well, and it makes so much sense. Like you had said that it's magnetizing, and it is your sense of radiance when you're in that sense of joy and fun. And I had a beautiful conversation with a woman this morning, and we were talking about, I mentioned fun and joy, and she said, yeah, those don't feel super accessible to me. And it is because they're wrapped up within the feminine energy. The feminine energy, as Kara just mentioned, is what allows us to have that, the fluidity and the expression and all of the pieces that feel really alive with no end game in sight, just for play, just for fun. Kara, I'm wondering, for those who maybe don't know who you are or haven't had the privilege of connecting with you before, can you share more about what it is? What do you do in this world?
Sure. A little intro. Yeah. So I am a master astrologer, also an Akashic Records practitioner. I love combining these tools together because they really just connect us back to our soul blueprint, our energetic blueprint, giving us clarity on our path and our purpose and what we're here to do in the world. And I love supporting the visionaries, creative, spiritual leaders of the world in really getting their message out there, getting their healing work out into the world and making the impact they came here to make and receiving abundantly for it. And I feel that's a big shift that we're stepping into right now is we are really beginning to value spiritual wisdom and healing gifts and stepping out of that old paradigm of, you know, the creative needing to struggle or not make money or the healer not making money. Like, it's time we shift out of that and really receive abundantly for the work that we do, because we all know, right? When big-hearted women have money, they do really amazing things with it in the world. And even just stepping up and owning the value of what we offer in whole new ways and allowing ourselves to be received and supported in new ways, so important, so important. Yeah. So that's, some of what I'm passionate about.
I love it. And I agree. I think that I can feel such a shift that it's almost like, okay, we're here. It is time for women to start valuing their worth, whether that's through sharing their business or even if that's just understanding that you get to feel wealthy, you get to feel abundant, you get to live a life that is full of incredibleness that lights you up. You no longer need to stick to that paradigm where you are supposed to be suffering to be healing. Instead, we're stepping into this place where individuals like myself and Kara are helping to hold the space for us all to shift that belief to come away from the lack consciousness and into the abundance. Because in that place is where we have more energy to serve and support those around us. It's where we have more drive, more motivation, more intention of what we're doing with our life. And women, let's be honest, we love spending money. We love shopping. We love sharing money. We love donating. The more wealth that you have flowing through your system, because money is energy, the more it's flowing through you, the more you get to share it in the directions and with the intentions that are true to your heart. In terms of donating to organizations that are making a difference, in terms of offering money perhaps to family, friends, or people that need that additional financial support without it being coming from a place of lack within, it is pure sharing and giving and unity connection together. And that's where, Kara, the work that you do and the work that I'm really stepping into as well is helping women claim that.
Yes. Oh, so beautifully said, Deanna. It's true. It's like when we're stressing over money or, you know, we're in that place of struggle, it's hard to fully be in our power, right? And create. And it's so, like, as you explain that, what I realized really shifted for me around money as well is when I started making it fun, going back to the idea of fun and playfulness, which I mean is really a theme of the full moon too. We're in the full moon energy today in Leo. So it's all about that creative self-expression and fun. But I noticed when I started applying that to money, it started to expand and grow. I had more in my bank account. I had more coming in when I got really playful about it and just thought about like all the amazing things I can do with money in the world, how fun it is to receive and to give and be in that exchange. Like, there's something that's magnetic about that energy. And also what you said, just, you know, yeah, feeling abundant in terms of money, but also all areas of our life, right? Just feeling abundant in our health, in our relationships, in our time freedom, like all of that is so important. Yeah.
One of the affirmations I've been working with for some time now is I am alive and turned on by my life. And I feel like it's just that something that really needed to shift within me where I would get into these phases where as an entrepreneur, for those of you who have your own business, you know this, there's a lot of things that still need to get done. There's still a lot of moving parts to running a business, whether it's online or a brick and mortar. There's still a lot of pieces to it. And I was getting myself into a state where I'd start feeling the heaviness of that, of like, oh, I have to do this. I have to get that done. No, I can't do this. I have to do this instead. And when I started shifting that, as you're saying, Kara, more into that sense of fun and coming into how could I be turned on by this? How could I be lit up? How could I be excited and feel alive? It activated that divine feminine energy. Mm-hmm. It activated the part of me that simply wanted to exist for the sake of existing. And that's what attracts and magnetizes more opportunities, more connections, more beautiful conversations, more clients, more money, all the things that you're craving to you.
Yeah. So
what are a couple things that you love to do to stay in that energy of fun and also in that divine feminine?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, there's definitely a few things. And I do like approach my business and life with it gets to feel fun. Now, that doesn't mean there's not things that come up that are not my favorite. I mean, like different aspects of business, right? Like some of the tech stuff can just drive me crazy. Or, you know, there's certain things that, yeah, again, just not my favorite. But I do come from that space of this gets to feel fun. So when those things come up, I ask myself how I can realign. So either change my mindset in how I'm approaching those tasks, delegate to someone else. And I'm honestly, like, I'm working on that now, building in more support, which I think is so, we need that, right? And we deserve that in our business. So that's something I'm working on, is calling in more of that support. But yeah, so it's, if those things come up, it's like changing my mindset around it, delegating it, and, you know, just allowing it to flow with greater ease, because we don't want to be in that energy of I have to do this to get a result. And we don't want to bring that heaviness into our business either, right? I mean, we start these businesses because they're supposed to feel fun and expansive. And, you know, I've noticed this, you know, a couple interesting progressions that I feel we go through in our business. Like when we initially begin, you know, we just want clients, right?
Yeah, I'll take anyone, come on.
I just want clients, and we want to make money doing what we love, and it's coming from a great spot. But we soon realize, okay, not every client, soul clients, right? And I think some of that is just learning by working with different people, talking about different things, and really finding what clicks for you. And then we also are like, okay, I want to be abundantly supported through my business, but we soon realize we don't want to be burnt out. We don't want to be working all the time. We want to have that space, and we want to have that balance. So I think, yeah, just going in with that intention of our business gets to feel good, right? It gets to feel good. It gets to feel fun. It gets to work for us too, right? It's like, what do I expect from my business? I think actually, yeah, I was doing a client call with someone today, and she said this, and it really stuck with me. She said she's starting to ask, like, what do I expect from my business? How do I expect it to show up? And it was just like a really, really fun shift for me as well to, you know, to be in that energy of, okay, like, how can this work for me? Because we don't just want to have a thriving business. We want to have a thriving life. So we do want to feel good in all our relationships. We want to have that time freedom, and we want to love what we're doing. And I think it's a constant of checking in and making those little tweaks in terms of the programs we're offering, the messaging, and taking that time and space for us. Like one of the things I love to do almost every night is I have an Epsom salt bubble bath. I love just sitting in the bath, and it's so recharging. And sometimes I'll listen to like chanting, or I'll put on like a podcast I like, or read, but just having that space to like relax and recharge. And also every morning I do like a morning meditation as well. So starting my day with that and ending my day with that. And, you know, not only those practices, but I think the real change is when we infuse like our daily life with those check-ins and really love what's on our calendar and our schedule. Like we're excited about it. Like that's what we deserve. And that's what we want to create in our business.
I love that. I love all of everything that you shared. And that last piece really hits home of you want to be working with clients that excite you. When I look at my calendar and see which clients I get to work with, whether coaching or a Reiki session, or if it's someone who's considering becoming a client, I get excited. I get so excited to see their names and feel into the energy of who they are and what it is they're currently moving through, or what they're working towards, or what the possibilities are. It's a lot of fun. And also things like this coming live here in the Empowered Woman Collective and sharing my colleagues and friends like Kara with this incredible community we have. These things are fun. They bring joy. If it wasn't joyful, I wouldn't do it, because that would be out of alignment with who I am and what I'm creating. Mm-hmm. For those of you who are watching, I'm curious what's landing so far. So from what we've been having in this conversation for the last 15 minutes, what is really anchoring in for you, or what have you had that's that moment of, I see, I've been looking at it this way, maybe I'll try this, or, oh great, okay, I'm already doing these things, I'm going to keep sticking to it. I want you to comment in what's coming up for you, even if you're watching the replay.
Yes.
And Kara, while we're waiting for some of those comments to come in, I'm really curious, How does this work with Akashic records? Like what role does that play in terms of activating our divine feminine, being in a state of fun and joy and bliss, calling in abundance, creating this business? What role do the Akashic records play?
Huge role. So the Akashic records really help connect us back to our infinite self. So who we are beyond the stories, beliefs, projections we've taken on. Like we have our human self, our ego self. And when I say ego, I don't even mean in a negative way, which sometimes we use it as just simply our persona, who we are, which is a beautiful thing. But then we also have our infinite self, who isn't attached to the stories and labels or identity even. And in the Akashic records, we get to more deeply connect to our higher self, our infinite self. And that's where we really see our true potential, what is really possible for us. And we begin to calibrate to that more and more in our life. So I think we do become more sensitive to where those fears are coming in, right? And we have higher standards in a good way. We're like, no, I get to feel good. I see what's possible for me. I see who I really am. And then we get to continually align to that. And it is a practice, right? Because we are still in human form. We're not perfect, but we get to align to what's really possible. So the joy, the freedom, the abundance, the business we desire, it's all there for us to claim. So it's just allowing ourselves to fully own that. And the records gives us like a glimpse of that possibility. And I think that's probably been and continues to be one of the biggest shifts that I've felt from being in the records is we transcend the fears and limitations, which with much more ease. When we lock in and we get a sense of that energy of what's really possible, it's just like we move through it. So it helps us calibrate to that. And again, we all have these doubts and fears. And I think especially in our business, it's normal to have that at any stage, right? Like I noticed some certain themes, like we always question, who am I to share this? Like imposter, is someone else already sharing this in a better way than I am? Like we have all these stories, but we also see in the records that if we have a desire in our heart, we're meant to share it with the world. Mm-hmm. And it really connects us back to like our blueprint. So what we are here to share, what we are here to be a channel for. So we gain that confidence in our message and our work, as well as the clarity piece too. So it's just such a game changer. And I see it time and time again in my clients, which is amazing. Like just being in that space, how it activates them, how it gets them to step up in new ways. And it's really like, it's incredible just to see that newfound sense of empowerment and confidence, because from that space, what you can create in your business and life in general is incredible once you have that sense of believing in yourself.
Yeah, it sounds like just really holding that foundation of aligning with your higher self and that infinite self and letting that be where you're either making decisions from or taking aligned action from, as opposed to from the part of you that is questioning, from the part of you that feels smaller, insignificant, or not worthy, all of those pieces, you're coming from that place of pure potentiality and possibility.
Absolutely. Yeah. And another thing that came through as you were speaking as well is this idea of relying more on our energy and less on just the action piece, which I think is really aligned with the divine feminine as well. Like we begin to see the power we hold through our energy and vibration and our frequency in the world. So it's not just the actions we're taking, but it's the energy behind it, right? Yes. So it's like we can show up and we can write a post or we can do a video, and you know, that action in itself can get momentum, but it's the energy and belief behind it, right? Mm-hmm. Are we having fun with it? Do we believe that we're going to make an impact, that it can be effective? Like that's really what drives it, right?
Yeah. Oh my goodness. I love that. Okay. So we have some comments. Lisa says, I'm sure your personal mood or state considerably improve as you continue to align more and more. But how do you honor hard times and emotions that surface while you are driving your business and keeping it from interfering?
Oh, that's a good question. I love that, Lisa, because we all have that. We all have that come up. And yeah, I'd love to hear your take on this too, Deanna. And I can definitely share as well. Do you want to share some insight first?
I do, absolutely. Lisa, I'm really glad you asked this, because I think this is something that every entrepreneur, especially someone who has an online business and is kind of like the face of their business in the online world, where we tend to put our best foot forward and we sometimes allude to things always being wonderful. And what I'm hearing in your question is, how do I allow myself to stay forward thinking and in this high vibrational state while also doing the deep inner healing work that is required, and sometimes just feeling crappy? And I think that the best thing that we can do is hold ourselves with grace all the time, as much as possible. So when you want to sit on the couch for a full day and watch Netflix, you let yourself do that if that's what's going to honor you at that time. I really love to take opportunities when I've been going through something heavy to, once I've moved through it, share about it socially. I tend not to when I'm in the depth of it, because I don't think that's the right place for me to show up as that leader. That's my personal preference. But I always make sure that I share it, because I think it's really important that we see that it's not just the pretty face all the time doing all the great things, that there's also the days when you don't do your hair and you don't want to get out of bed, or things are challenging and there's struggles in your family, or maybe the money's not quite coming in yet, or what else is going on. I think the greatest thing that you can do is hold yourself in grace, forgiveness and love, compassion and grace, and know that this is a part of you aligning higher.
Oh, beautifully said, Deanna. Oh, I love that. Yeah. And I totally agree. I think it's so much power in sharing our journey and story. And I also agree, not when we're in the midst of it, because I think anytime we put our story or a piece of us out into the world, we are going to get projections and we're going to get other people's energy surrounding it. And we want to be aware of that. And I think we want to be in a space where we have done a certain amount of healing or we're secure, and then we put it out into the world. But I feel that in itself can be really healing as well and really empowering when we take our journey and we take our lessons and then we share it with the world. And I also love that idea of just being patient with ourselves. Like, we are human, and since our business, I think, especially in what we do as healers and light workers, like, we are so involved in that. Like, our business in many ways is us, right? So when we go through those times, that's when we really have an opportunity to show up for ourselves, right? Mm-hmm. To really show up and lead ourselves in powerful ways. And that will come through in other areas of our business, or we'll then be able to hold space for our clients as they go through those challenging times. So I think being loving and patient, and I also see it as an opportunity of, now I really get to apply these skills. Now I really get to tap into these resources and I get to show up for me. Like, that's how I see it. Yeah.
I love that. Thanks for that beautiful answer. And Lisa, we would love to know your thoughts and takeaways from that as well. And Heather says, I think this is your takeaway thus far. Honoring my energy, honoring my flow has allowed me to be in balance with my creative work, my writing, my business, and allowed me to dream with pure abandonment. When my energy is aligned with the work is joyful, fun, and flows with ease.
Beautiful. That's so beautifully said, Heather.
So beautiful.
Hearing that. So powerful. Yeah. Yeah. It's that alignment. And what just came through too, because I know maybe people are watching this and they're like, well, how do I get to alignment? Should I not show up, right? If I'm not in alignment. And, you know, I don't think any of us are always like 100% of the time in alignment. And I do still feel it's important that, you know, we are showing up, that we're still showing up. But how I've come to see it is, like, anytime where I'm frustrated or overwhelmed, and there's a part of me that wants to push through and show up anyway, probably that masculine energy and that drive of, like, do it anyway, you've got a goal, you've got to keep going. And in some ways that served me very well. But I also, you know, see it as a priority now. Like, number one, how do I get back into alignment? Right? So if I am feeling off, what do I do? And again, that can be like a meditation, and can even just be taking like 10 minutes just to listen to music, or even between like my calls today or interviews, just taking that space before, you know, I connect with someone, just to breathe and be. Yeah. Taking that, yeah, space. Us, right? So it's not like any of us are always perfectly aligned, but I think it's knowing what we can draw on to bring ourselves back there, and that we still get to show up and we can still make a beautiful impact, even if we're not perfectly.
Well, and I think that sometimes it's a really powerful impact when you do show up and you're not in full alignment, but you declare that. And yep. You allow it to be known, like, hey, this is how I'm feeling today. This is where I'm at. And this is why I'm showing up, or this is the way in which I'm choosing to show up. Because as you guys know, social media tends to be that highlight reel. And it is really hard when, even if we think that we're not doing it, that we're comparing how we're feeling inside, which oftentimes when we're just scrolling through online, we're not feeling great. And we're comparing it with everybody else's perfectly poised, put together, highlighted photo with a caption that is just so beautifully poetic and all these things. It's important to remember that the reason that those photos can be so beautiful and that caption can be so well written is because there's also space being created for the inner work to occur, for that shadow work, for the dark energy to be present so that you can begin to bring the light into it. I think that's very crucial, especially if your work is holding space for others in their healing. Is that, like, I take this so seriously, and Kara, I have a good sense that you do too. I am never without support for my own personal healing, because I'm not willing to hold space for another to be their coach, to offer them energy healing, to help them, give them any guidance. I'm not willing to do that unless I'm already going deeper in my own healing as well. It's so crucial to me.
Oh, I love that. Absolutely. And that's something I didn't do at the beginning of my business. What I would do is I'd wait until I felt stuck again, and then I would reach out, right? And it would break me free of that. And then it finally clued in, well, if I just had that ongoing support,
right?
Grow a lot faster and just feel that. I mean, yeah, I think having that mentor and that secret container, it's like, it's someone to celebrate with. It's somebody that can hold that space when you are having challenges. It's someone that infuses new ideas into what you're creating. Like, it's just all around, it's so supportive. And we deserve that, right? And that's something I'm feeling into more and more, not just in terms of mentors, but as I grow out a team, like, what kind of support do I need, right? Because it's we deserve it. It's so necessary. And I do think we do expand our business more quickly when we have that. No question, we do.
Absolutely. We have a foundation of support. And fun fact, everybody, I don't know if any of you know this, but Kara and I actually share the most incredible virtual assistant. Her name is Jess. Jess, if you're watching this, we love you, and it's so much fun knowing that you serve both of our companies, that you serve both of us in such a beautiful way. And I mean, I can only speak for myself, but I absolutely love working with Jess. And it's really special when you release competition in any way. It allows you to actually share resources in such a big open way. And so allowing Jess to also work with Kara is just like letting ourselves both have that support. It just feels so sacred, and like we're even more connected. It's so much more fun.
Yes, and I so appreciate you connecting the two of us, because I was really holding that intention that I wanted VA to come in. That was just like a perfect match, and it was. So
she's amazing.
Yeah, wow. Yeah, really good.
So Lisa says, beautiful responses. I love the thought of honoring what is and then coming back and sharing it with the purpose of processing and giving hope and healing to others. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. That's so beautiful, Lisa. So Kara, one of the things that you were just talking about, how important it is to be in sacred container and to be in community. Now, I know that coming up, there's something that you have been sharing about, and it's this beautiful new container that you've created that from what I've seen, and we've gotten to know each other quite a bit over this past year, this is like it is a powerful container. Can you take a moment and share about this with us for those of you who are watching and know that being in Kara's energy and her presence and her community is somewhere you want to be moving forward?
Absolutely. Yes. It's the Akashic Inner Circle. And it's
wait. Can you just say that again?
The Akashic Inner Circle.
It feels so good just to say that, just to hear that. The Akashic Inner Circle. Okay, sorry.
Keep going. Thank you for that, because it was really like I've been feeling the divine downloads coming in around this for a while, of wanting to create this container for women to come together, expand their business, but also evolve and grow spiritually. And I was patient with it, right? Like all our creations, I think they have to take some time, right? And especially like creations like this. So I really sat with it, and it was interesting as we started to like come into this new year and even the Aquarian age, it really just began to drop in. And I think part of that is we're seeing a rise of a new spiritual leader right now. Like we really are a new way of doing business, a new way of showing up. So I feel this creation came in at the perfect time to really just support lightworkers in getting their work out there in a bigger way in the world and feeling really confident in doing that. But what's really unique about this container is it will massively expand your business. Absolutely. I'll give you the strategies, the tools, the energetic work to do that. But it's also about evolving spiritually. So like fine tuning your intuitive gifts and experiencing wealth in all levels of your life. So yes, the financial financial wealth, but also like what we spoke about, Deanna, just feeling good in your body, happy in your relationships, and having a business that like works for you. It creates the freedom lifestyle. It's a vehicle for getting your message out into the world. And also what's so special about this container is it includes one-on-one work as well as the group component. So we can really dive deep and make sure you're getting those results that you want. Because I actually haven't done something yet that's combined both. I have group programs. I have my incredible academy. I've worked with clients one-on-one, but this is bringing them both together, the one-on-one and the group. And I feel there's something really special about that that allows you to accelerate really quickly and just connect deeply to the work you're here to do and share in the world and really gain deep clarity on that and a deep level of confidence in it.
Yeah, I think that's wonderful. I think there's a lot of power in having both one-on-one and group. And I've noticed I personally love being supported one-on-one. I love having an intimate coach or currently two coaches that are there holding space for me and getting really like into the depths of who I am, helping me see where I'm blocking myself. But I also love the aspect of community because for any of you who are entrepreneurs, you probably know that sometimes it can feel isolating. And so I think it's really powerful that you brought these two together so that whoever it is that knows that they're meant to be in this container with you gets to have that dual level of support.
Yeah, absolutely. I think just being around other people who have a similar mission and message, we're all doing it in our own unique way, but just being in that energy,
yeah,
it really lifts us up, right? Like we calibrate to it and we step up in new ways. And of course, in these containers, it's so much support. It's so much love. There's like, there'll be collaborative opportunities, I'm sure, that come out of that as well. And just so much inspiration. But I think that community is really powerful. And again, we are in the Aquarian age, which is about connection and community. So I really wanted to have that piece. And I think we're all craving that now and like connection with our soul tribe, our soul family, people that get us, right? They get the challenges and the obstacles. They get that we dream big and we do things differently.
We feel big, we dream big, everything we do is big.
Exactly. It's out there in the best of ways, but being surrounded in that community is just, there's power in that. I've seen it time and time again. And then of course the individual is, it's just so personalized to what you're needing, right? Clearing through the fears that you have, helping you create a plan to get to your next level. So it's, I'm really excited about it. And again, like all these creations, they feel like they have an energy of their own. So it's really fun to like co-create with it and just see the people that are drawn to the space and be able to grow and evolve with them. Yeah.
Absolutely. I love that. I love what you shared. Taylor, I'm glad that you're here, even though you thought it was at two. We're just starting to wrap up. But for those of you who have been here, if you have any questions for Kara right now, anything specifically about the Akashic Inner Circle or the Akashic Records or Divine Feminine Energy, anything that's burning on your heart that you want to ask or ask me, go ahead and comment that in right now. Mm-hmm. Now, I mentioned in the description that Kara and I had just like a little special something that we would announce. And I know from the many times before that I brought Kara into our community here that a lot of you absolutely adore her. And we wanted to create an opportunity where you would get to be able to work with both of us. And we wanted to create that experience where you could be in the energy of both of us for an extended period of time. So what we have done, what we've created for you is for any of you that choose to join Kara in her Akashic Inner Circle and receive all of that support, the one-on-one support she mentioned, having the community support, being in this soul tribe of individuals that are deeply supporting you in your expansion. If you decide that's what you want to do, then you're going to be invited to a very special virtual retreat with both myself and Kara. And this retreat is called Expanding Your Influence Through Aligning with Goddess Energy.
So good. I'm so excited for this. Like I know, Deanna, you've been receiving downloads around this and sharing it with me, right? And I'm like, oh, yes, this sounds amazing.
Yes, absolutely. And this is, so what we're going to be doing for those of you who will be joining us is we're going to be pulling both of our skill sets and our tools and our energetic abilities together to really take you on this incredible journey of tapping into the Akashic Records and tapping into that infinite self of who you are, allowing yourself to align with it in your body so your body can start to come and calibrate at that energetic level of your infinite being. And then from there, we're going to start actualizing how you desire to connect and communicate with your soulmate clients. So you're actually going to walk away with some resources and tools that you can use right away, like tangible things you can use right away within your business to start cultivating more of that connection with those who are meant to be working with you and your sacred gifts.
Just magical. I already feel the energy of this, and I know it's going to be just so, so powerful because it is the energetic. But then from there, like Diana said, there will be tangible tools you can implement right away. And because you have the energy, the tools work. I always think we need the energy in order for the strategies and techniques to work. So we'll make sure that we're, you know, doing high level work in the Akashic Records to really ensure you're calibrated, you're connected to what you're here to share. And then those practical tools you can walk away with and apply in your business right away to draw in your soulmate clients. So it's going to be magical. And just the idea of doing a retreat right now where we can't really travel in person and connect, like just taking that time and space, like, it'll just be so rejuvenating as well as so supportive for your business growth.
Yeah, I'm really excited for it, Kara. I think it's going to be amazing. And for those of you, Emily said she's stoked to catch the replay. Awesome. Thanks for being here with us, Heather. So Kara, if someone is interested in joining you for the Akashic Inner Circle and joining us for this beautiful virtual retreat that we're going to be offering as their beautiful thank you or beautiful gift for saying yes to themselves, what do they need to do?
Yeah. So you can just reach out to me on Facebook. And of course, just let me know you saw Diana and I together today in the show. Or you can reach out to Diana as well, either of us, and we can chat with you about it and just make sure it's the right space for you. I'm also opening up room to jump on a call with you just to ensure that this is the right fit. So we can definitely jump on a call and I can just learn more about what you're working toward in your business right now, what you desire to create and explore more of the inner circle and see if it is the right fit for you. Because I really want everyone coming into this container to feel and know this is right for them. So I'm absolutely open to jumping on a call with you and exploring that and how it can support you.
I really love that. That's a great idea. And it's closing soon, isn't it? Like, I think there's only open for
a few days now. A few days left. We're in like, yeah, the finale.
The finale.
So we are beginning soon. Yeah. So definitely if you're interested, make sure you reach out over the next few days and I can chat to you about that. Or again, if you feel more comfortable reaching out to Diana, she has the details on this space as well. So yeah, I would love to welcome you in if it's speaking to you and you know you're ready to just expand and grow your business. You're done with the struggle and overwhelm. There's support there. There's tools that are available. It's so possible for you. It's so possible. Don't try to figure it out on your own.
I love that. I think that's where we all need to keep stepping into is that that instead of like, what do I have to do to get what I want or what needs to occur or what do I need to learn or who do I need to be? What's possible? What could happen? What do I desire? Coming into more of that energy. And the greatest way that I have found to stay in that energy is to be surrounded by community that helps lift you there. And when you are surrounded by others that inspire you, that invigorate you, that lift you up with a sense of life and liveliness, that's what allows you to stay there more often. And it feels really good.
So good, right? And we deserve that. And I love what you said, just leaning in more to like, what if it does work? Like sometimes our mind goes to
what if it could be easy? What if saying yes to the Akashic Inner Circle was such an easy decision that knowing that you have Kara's support was exactly what you've been calling in for yourself? Could you bring yourself to a place of seeing, feeling, and living that possibility?
Yeah. And it just feels good to say that, right? To just feel into what is possible for us and to say yes without shooting it down right away. You know, like with any of our desires, it's like, oh, I desire this. But then the doubts come in. It's like, but can I do this? Is this possible? Or what if worst case scenarios? But instead, if we lean in and what if it does work? What if this changes my business? What if this changes my financial situation? What if this changes what I'm able to create? Like lean into the good what ifs.
Yeah, I love that. And I find that when you do that, that's when your intuitive guidance comes through more strongly because you're not already blocking yourself with those ways of trying to like, okay, how am I going to figure this out? What is this going to look like? I don't know if that's possible. When you let yourself be in the possible, you'll feel that guidance from within as to whether this is a full yes or a full no or wherever it is you're guided. By releasing that resistance, you let your own inner guide, that part of who you are, guide you. And if that's challenging, then maybe this is where you should be.
It's a lot of energy and space when we just make those decisions, right? Instead of being on the fence. So whether it's like a no or a yes, and then we actually honor where our guidance system is taking us. Because we, yeah, and I say this from experience. I used to be so indecisive. it's a drainer, right?
Just exhausting.
It's exhausting. It's exhausting. And it really slows momentum. And like you said, when we just trust, like it strengthens our intuition when we trust those instincts and impulses and we honor them. Like we really just get in flow with our intuition in whole new ways.
Yeah. I love this. Kara, thank you so much for joining us today and coming and sharing your wisdom and your beautiful face and your voice in the Empowered Woman Collective. It's always just such a delight to have you here and hear all of your wisdom. Thank you.
Oh, thank you, Deanna. It's always an honor to be here. I love connecting with you. I love being in this empowering space and always just such a fun, free flow conversation, which I love. So thank you.
Yeah, we have a lot of fun together. And so ladies, thank you for joining us. Whether you've been here with us live, thank you. That's so much fun. And for those of you who are watching the replay, we're really happy that you took the time to dive in and engage with this conversation that we got to have and share with you today. And if you have any questions about Kara or the Akashic Inner Circle or the virtual retreat that we're hosting, go ahead and send either myself or Kara a message, or you can comment in and one of us will connect with you. And just sending you so much love for a really abundant, beautiful, and prosperous day. Mwah.
Bye. Ciao.